So jumping on to the next issue, and this issue concerns the licensed customs broker exam, which took place on October 8th, 2020. So last week, customs came out with a message saying that there were concerns about the usual stuff, actually, the concerns about the IT portion. There were some kind of delays, there were some kind of IT issues which some test centers experienced, and as a result of that, many of them were some examinees they experienced the delay in a way the customs were able to administer the exam, and it kind of caused delays in ability of examinees to conduct stuff in a timely manner, allegedly. So this week, customs came out with, today, customs came out with another message. And this time, customs was saying is that, listen, so they say at some testing locations, applicants encountered systems issues, while other applicants did not experience any delays throughout the examination. And then they say a thorough examination was conducted, and it was determined that there was no time lost for the majority of the customs broker license exam testers. And this is the key here, okay? So what customs is saying is that majority, and the buzzword here is majority of customs broker license exam testers did not experience loss of time. So this means that the majority of testers, regardless of the delays, had access to the exam for the time frame allotted. All right, so that kind of, even though they indirectly say that the results, individual results, will be sent in the 3 to 5 weeks, I'm not sure if this implies a new doctrine that customs examiners and customs as an agency as a whole have developed. So pretty much what they say is this. So as long as majority of customs broker license examinees, and majority, well, I guess here it plainly means more than 50%. So if 51%, for example, which is a majority, did not experience delays, but other 49% experienced the delays, then that means that whatever the delays the other 49% have experienced, let's say a minority, whatever delays minority have experienced, that really means that those guys have a tough luck. We're still going to proceed with grading. We're still going to proceed with all the usuals as if nothing has happened. So this pretty much, I haven't seen that type of interpretation before. And there really is, I mean, when there were delays, I believe there was a case-by-case basis ability of customs to allow for examinees to sit on the next exam for free. I'm not sure if this is going to be the case here. They do not say that explicitly in the message, but at the very least, one should be mindful that this majority versus minority doctrine announced by customs today is kind of concerning, because it says, okay, if again, I'm hoping I'm incorrect, but it sounds like what customs is saying is, listen, as long as minority, and by minority, mathematically speaking, that would be 49% or less of individuals who sit through the exam experience the delays, it doesn't really matter. We don't care. We only need to be concerned with the majority. And we'll proceed as usual, business as usual, in other words. So this is kind of concerning. I think there will be some clarifications with respect to the further developments that will take place. But like I said, in the past, customs did allow those people that were affected to take the customs license broker exam for free during the next session. So customs also posted the copies of the customs license broker exams. So they are not posted with answers. They are posted with they're just questions for now. So there were two sessions, right? There is an AM session and PM session. Customs posted both. So the link is provided. You're welcome to check it out. Customs do have a tendency to post the exams later on anyway. And I'm talking about the answers. So I think it will show up within the next few weeks or so. With respect to the answers to the exam themselves, at least in a PDF form on that website.